Hello friends, our topic is the search for genetic material. In previous chapter we have studied about the discovery done by Mendel, the father of genetics, and he had given three laws of inheritance and concluded that the factors represent the letter on genes are responsible to carry and transfer the characters from generation to generation. But the question arises here that what molecule was actually the genetic material, either the DNA, RNA or protein. Just to find out which molecule is responsible to carry the characters, number of experiments has been done by different scientists. And one of them, the scientist, the Frederick Griffth, he had done the series of experiments on Streptococcus bacteria and given a principle, and that principle is named as transforming principle. For this experiment, he cultured this bacteria and obtained two strains of bacteria, Streptococcus bacteria. First is smooth type, denoted as S type, which has outer covering of mucus, that is polysaccharide. That bacteria, the S strain bacteria, causes disease, then pneumonia. And it is a so-called valent bacteria. Second is a rough type of bacteria, this type of bacteria do not have mucus covering and not able to cause a disease, pneumonia. Now he injected this bacteria into mice and given the conclusion that the transforming principle, the something is there which is responsible to carry the characters, forward the characters from generation to generation. Transforming principle. In 1928, Frederick Griffth done series of experiments in Streptococcus pneumonia, which causes disease pneumonia. He cultured this bacteria and obtained two strains, S type and R type. S type of strain, this type of bacteria, they have covering of mucus which is violent and causes disease pneumonia. While the other R type, mentioned as rough type, it do not have mucus covering and do not cause pneumonia. Now he injected these two strains one by one into mice and observed a series of results. When he injected S type of bacteria, which is violent, having an outer covering of mucus, injected into mice, the mice died. Then he done R type of bacteria and injected into mice, the mice remain alive. Then third experiment what he has done, he has taken S type of heat killed bacteria. What he has done, that S type which is violent, and he killed it, bacteria, by heating this, and injected into mice, the mice alive. The major difference from the S type, when it is living, this S type, it is a living. While in the third experiment of series, he has used S type of bacteria, which is heat killed. When injected into mice, the mice alive. Now then, fourth experiment, what he has done, he has taken S type heat killed bacteria with R type living bacteria and injected into mice. Mice died. The question arises, how is it possible? If the S type heat killed in the above experiment, this S type heat killed the mice alive, and the R type of bacteria which is living and it is non-violent, not able to cause disease, then how it is possible that the mice died due to pneumonia? And the miraculous result was that when he recovered the living S type of bacteria from the dead mice, that from this dead mice he recovered living S type of bacteria. Then how is it possible if both of them, they are not living? So he concluded that R strain bacteria had somehow been transformed by heat killed S strain. Means something has given the instruction to form the mucous membrane or the polysaccharide covering. So he concluded that something is transferred from S type to made R type to synthesize mucus coat and become violent. From this experiment, so that conclusion is not appropriate. From this experiment, it is not clear about the nature of the genetic material. He was not able to give the idea about that either the DNA has given the instruction to make the R strain into S strain to form the polysaccharide covering. Either the RNA is responsible for that or the protein is responsible to give the instruction. So in this experiment, that Frederick Griffith was not able to give the appropriate answer. That which one is the genetic material or the molecule is responsible to transfer the vector. Number of scientists, they uses the benefits of the but the other scientists conducted experiment by taking the help of these experiments like Mc.Leod, McCarty, and concluded that DNA is a genetic material. Biochemical characterization of transforming principle. In previous video, we have discussed about the Griffith experiment and he concluded that something is transferred from heat killed S strain and made the S strain bacteria to synthesize smooth polysaccharides coat due to which mice died. Here the question arises, what do this something stand for? Something, either the DNA or the RNA, protein or the carbohydrate, they are responsible to carry the characters. Just to find out this something, Mc.Leod, McCarty and Colin Mc.Leod, they worked to determine the biochemical nature of the transforming principle. Just to determine whether the DNA or the RNA, the protein, polysaccharides, they are responsible out of these four, which one is responsible to carry the characters from generation to generation. For this, they have done series of experiments. The first, they have done the DNA extracted from S heat-killed bacteria. It means that they have taken out the DNA of that bacteria which is heat-killed and injected into living R cell. And what they concluded that the R cell transformed into S cell. That the result is that R cell transformed into S cell. Then what they have done in second series of experiment, they have again taken the DNA extract from heat-killed bacteria and they digest the DNA with the help of an enzyme that is DNase. It is a DNA digesting enzyme and injected into living R cell. And the result is no transformation occurred. Then third series, they have taken out the protein extract from the S heat-killed bacteria and inserted into living R cell. And they found there will be no transformation. Fourth series, they have taken out the polysaccharides of heat-killed bacteria and inserted into living R cell. The result, no transformation. Then the fifth, that RNA from the S heat-killed bacteria injected into living R cell. The result is no transformation. The result was no transformation. And the last one is that they have taken out the RNA from S strain heat-killed bacteria and digest the RNA by using RNA digesting enzyme RNase and inserted into living R cell. The result, no transformation. So out of these six series of experiments, only the DNA extract, which is taken out from the S heat-killed bacteria, injected into R cell bacteria, capable to transform the R cell into S cell. And rest of these five experimental series, there was no transformation. So that it means that the DNA is only the material molecule which is responsible to transfer the character. And he concluded on the basis of these number of series of experiments, they have given the conclusion that only the DNA is responsible to transfer the character from generation to generation. Experiment to show DNA is a genetic material. In previous video, we came to know that the conclusion given by the Mc.Leod and Mc.Leod that DNA is genetic material. But the experiment that they have given that based biochemical nature of that. So all the scientists, they are not convinced that conclusion given by Mc.Leod and Mc.Leod. So another scientist, they also worked on this topic that DNA is genetic material with the viruses that infect bacteria called bacteriophage. Hershey and Chase experiment, named as a Hershey and Chase experiment. They worked on viruses that infect bacteria, and that is called as a bacteriophage. Bacteriophage attaches to the bacteria and enter its genetic material like this. This is bacteriophage. They attaches to the bacteria named as E. coli, and they transfer their genetic material into the E. coli. And that the basic nature of the virus is that they incorporate it into the bacterial viruses and the bacterial cell, and they multiply themselves. The virus multiply themselves very fast. So what they have done, Hershey and Chase, first of all they grew bacteria, that is the bacteriophage, on a medium containing radioactive phosphorus, and some of the bacteria they cultured in on radioactive S35. The reason behind this is that viruses that grown on medium P32 had radioactive DNA. That those viruses which grown on the medium P32, they had a radioactive DNA. Why? Because DNA contain phosphorus but not protein. So the radioactive phosphorus, that is P32, easily incorporated into the DNA. But those viruses or the bacteriophage grown on the medium S35 had radioactive protein only, but not the radioactive DNA, because the DNA do not have sulfur. So S35 is only incorporated into the protein coat. So that's why, because the protein has a sulfur content, so easily radioactive S35, it enters into the protein coat of bacteriophage. So the two type of bacteriophage they obtained, and they named as a protein that is labeled as S35, and that another bacteriophage as labeled that DNA as a P32. Because why P32? Because phosphorus is a part of DNA, so easily incorporated into the DNA, so labeled as P32. But S35 is not a part of DNA but is a part of protein, so easily incorporated into a protein coat. Now the next step, that he attaches these bacteriophage or cultured the bacteriophage which is labeled as S35 and P32 on E. coli. This one also attaches to E. coli, and P32 also, that is E. coli. They infect this bacteria, E. coli, and that stage is called as a infection. Now the blending phase, that the DNA of this bacteria mixes with the DNA of a bacteriophage. Now the centrifugation, they multiply very fast. E. coli within 20 minutes it multiply very fast. The multiplicative phase starts. So the after that the last step is centrifugation, that is called as agitation, rotation. Now what they have detected, that the observation is that they have taken out the DNA of this bacteria, and what they observed that no radioactive S35 detected from the cell. That is, there was no content of S35 in bacterial cell. But the protein coat, which is that from the bacterial cells, no radioactive S35 detected from the cell, but S35 detected from the supernatant, that is from the protein coat. It means that genetic material is DNA here. It do not have any radioactive molecule or the content, that is P32 or S35, as it is labeled as radioactive S35. But in the bacterial cell, S35 was not detected. But in the supernatant, the P35, radioactive 35 is present. It is not present in the bacterial cell. It is outside from the bacteria. That's why it is not a genetic material. Protein is not a genetic material. But in this case, when they detected the DNA of this cell or the bacteriophage E. coli, that it contained radioactive P32 that detected from the bacterial cell. But no radioactive P32 from the supernatant, that is from the protein coat. So it means that the DNA from this bacteriophage transfer into bacterial cell, that is the E. coli, then incorporated in the DNA of the E. coli. That's why it is easily detected from the bacterial cell. But in the supernatant, which is present outside the cell, bacterial cell, it do not have any radioactive substance. That's why by this experiment we can conclude that the conclusion given by Hershey and Chase, that DNA is a genetic material, which is accepted by all the scientists. Thank you.